So now let us start with our next chapter, that is of our environment. So that is the chapter, our environment. First of all, what do you understand by the term environment? What is environment? Question for your notebook. The first question for your notebook is, what do you understand by the term environment? What are its components? What do you understand by the term environment and what are its components? So our environment means that is our surroundings, right? Whatsoever the things that make up our surroundings, that makes up our environment, right? For example, if I say, what is your environment? Here sitting in the class, offline students, what is your environment? What are your surroundings? Your surroundings have the other students. Okay, that is the students, those who are present here in the class. Then there are microbes that are present in the air. They are all the biotic factors. Biotic kya hota hai? Living, jo components hai aapke environment ke, that are the biotic factors. Aur kya hai aapke environment mein? All the table, chairs, notebook, copy, pen, jo bhi aapne pakda hua hai, hai na? That all makes your abiotic environment. Abiotic means non-living things, that which are associated with you. Even the temperature condition, that is also associated with you. Aapko garmi lag rahi hai ya aapko theek lag raha hai, whatsoever, that is because of the temperature. There is also humidity, the moisture content. These all account for the abiotic component. So what is our environment? That is our surrounding. And what are the components of this? The components of our environment, that are, what are the components? They are biotic and abiotic factors. Abiotic and biotic components. Biotic are the living components. Matlab living cheeze jo hain, they make up your biotic environment. What is abiotic environment or abiotic component of the environment? That are all the non-living things that which will be making your abiotic environment. Clear? So that is our environment. Here we say ki ye sari cheeze present hain. कुछ हम यूज कर रहे हैं कुछ नहीं. फॉर एग्जाम्पल यहाँ पे इस क्लास में अगर बैठे हैं तो स्टूडेंट्स आर सेइंग दैट द एबायोटिक कंपोनेंट्स आर ऑल द बेंचेस व्हिच आर हियर इन अवर सराउंडिंग. दे आर देयर बट वी आर नॉट यूजिंग ऑल, वी आर यूजिंग जस्ट वन, है ना. अ फ्यू ऑफ द कंपोनेंट्स आर नॉट इंटरैक्टिंग विद अस. कहने का मतलब ये, हम उनके साथ हमारा कुछ रिलेशन नहीं है, हमारा कुछ भी इंटरेक्शन नहीं है, हम उनके ऊपर डिपेंडेंट नहीं है, वो हमारे ऊपर डिपेंडेंट नहीं है, ठीक है. ऐसे जो कंपोनेंट्स जब हमारे पास आते हैं, जब कंपोनेंट्स एक दूसरे के ऊपर इंटरैक्ट नहीं कर रहे हैं, दे डिपेंडेंट नहीं हैं, तो वो सिंपल हमारे एनवायरनमेंट के पार्ट है, दैट्स इट. बट व्हेन दे आर फ्रेंडली इंटरैक्टिंग विद यू, फ्रेंडली इंटरैक्शन मींस दैट दे आर बेनिफिटिंग यू एंड यू आर बेनिफिटिंग देम. आपको उनसे फायदा हो रहा है, वो आपको फायदा दे रहे हैं, देन वी कॉल दैट पर्टिकुलर एनवायरनमेंट एज इकोसिस्टम, राइट. सो व्हाट इज इकोसिस्टम? दैट्स अ सेकंड क्वेश्चन फॉर यू. What is ecosystem and what are its components? What is ecosystem and what are its components? Ecosystem is the friendly interaction. This is the friendly interaction among the biotic and abiotic components of environment. Among the biotic and abiotic components of environment. Biotic and abiotic things which are present in our surroundings, in one's surroundings, that if interacting friendly with one another will create an ecosystem, right? The most common and the largest of all the ecosystems, natural ecosystems, is the forest. You know, forest is an ecosystem. And how all, everything that is interacting with one another, the animals are dependent upon the plants in the forest, the plants are equally dependent upon the animals, hai na, seed dispersal ke liye, carbon dioxide ke liye, theek hai, ye sari cheezon mein interactions ho rahi hain. Animals are dependent upon the plants and plants are dependent upon animals, both are benefiting one another for food, for energy, everything, right. Then there is temperature conditions, humidity, soil ki pH, soil ke liye humidity chahiye, temperature chahiye, kisi ke liye theek hai, kisi ke liye nahi hai, but that is again benefiting one another, theek hai. So ye kya hai? That is all, everything in that ecosystem, in the forest ecosystem, that is all interacting in a friendly nature, that is always giving the benefit to one another. What will be the components of this ecosystem? As I said, it's friendly interaction between biotic and abiotic. So they are the same components of the ecosystem as well. So components, agar humse ecosystem se puche ya environment se puche, so that are same. It's biotic components and abiotic components. Got it? So what is our environment? That is our surroundings. And what is the ecosystem? In the surroundings, the friendly interacting components that create a ecosystem. Clear? Right. Now here one thing I spoke out, that these are dependent upon one another for food and energy. When there is a dependence of the organisms on others for food and energy, they get interlinked, they get interdependent. एक के ऊपर दूसरा जो है वो डिपेंडेंट हो जाएगा. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, अगर टाइगर को डियर को खाना है तो टाइगर को डियर को लेना है, खाना है, वो डिपेंडेंट है. ठीक है, जो अगर डियर अवेलेबल नहीं होगा तो टाइगर भी भूखा मरेगा. ठीक है, सो दैट इज दे आर हैविंग द फूड एंड एनर्जी फ्रॉम द अदर ऑर्गेनिज्म, दे आर डिपेंडेंट अपॉन वन अनदर, दैट व्हाट क्रिएट्स द फूड चेन. सो दिस इज नेक्स्ट, व्हाट इज अ फूड चेन. द थर्ड थिंग, थर्ड क्वेश्चन फ्रॉम दिस चैप्टर for your fair notebooks, that is, what is a food chain? What is a food chain? It is the interdependence or interlinking, interdependence or interlinking of various living organisms, various organism, likho, living mein food chain hota hai वैसे, decomposers food chain mein nahi aate hain. But still they are dependent for food and energy, right? So it is interdependence or interlinking of the various organisms for food and energy. For food and energy. Why do they require this food and energy? Why are they interdependent? क्यों चाहिए है? क्यों ये interdependence हुआ? क्यों इनको ये food और energy चाहिए है? क्या ये इसके बगैर नहीं रह सकते? No. That is for the survival of these living organisms, the food and energy is required. For having the food and energy, they are interdependent. Clear? So all the words of this definition are very important. Clear? You can't miss even a single word from the definition. Got it? So this is a food chain. Now food chain that runs in the different of the ecosystems differently. ठीक है, food chain जो होता है, that is an interlinking. वेरियस ऑर्गेनिज्म लिंक्ड हैं. ठीक है, अगर एक ऑर्गेनिज्म दूसरे को खाएगा तो वैसा ही चेन चलेगा. ठीक है, दैट इज दे आर हैविंग द स्पेसिफिक लेवल्स, राइट? सो दैट इज द चेन विच इज क्रिएटेड आफ्टर द इंटरलिंकिंग ऑफ ऑल द ऑर्गेनिज्म, दैट क्रिएट्स द फूड चेन, राइट? इन द फूड चेन एवरी ऑफ द ऑर्गेनिज्म हैज इट्स ओन, यू कैन से स्पेस और अ पोजिशन. ठीक है, एवरी ऑर्गेनिज्म हैज इट्स स्पेसिफिक पोजीशन इन अ फूड चेन. व्हाट डू वी कॉल टू दैट पर्टिकुलर स्पेसिफिक पोजीशन? वी कॉल इट एज ट्रॉफिक लेवल्स. व्हाट आर ट्रॉफिक लेवल्स? इन अ फूड चेन एवरी ऑर्गेनिज्म ऑक्यूपाइज, इन अ फूड चेन एवरी ऑर्गेनिज्म ऑक्यूपाइज अ स्पेसिफिक पोजीशन, दैट इज कॉल्ड एज ट्रॉफिक लेवल. Clear? Now to study the trophic levels and food chains in three of the different ecosystems, further are the examples for this. What are the examples and what are these three ecosystems in which we have to study? For this, bache, you will be writing now further in a landscape form. Okay, landscape copy pakad lo and then you write down whatever I am going to write further. That are the examples of the different ecosystems along with their trophic levels. Okay, write it in the form of a landscape. These are first column of this table that comprises of trophic levels. Okay, then three ecosystems we have to study, the food chain in the three ecosystems. The first ecosystem is grassland ecosystem, second is forest ecosystem, and the third one is aquatic ecosystem. So these are the examples of three ecosystems. तीन ecosystem, तीन ही पढ़ने हैं आपने एनसीईआरटी में, तीन ही given है तो तीन ही पढ़ने हैं, ठीक है? Three ecosystems along with the trophic levels we have to write, right? Make out four columns of this table. After this, starting with the first of the food chain, that is in the grassland ecosystem. But always remember, when you are writing your food chain in a vertical manner, like this, okay, in a vertical manner, always start the food chain from the bottom and go towards the top. Okay, you have to always start it from the bottom, go towards the top. Clear? If you are writing it horizontally, that is as according to your lines in the notebook, agar aise likh rahe, then you move from left to right. Okay, for writing any of the food chain vertically, if you have to start from the bottom. So grassland ecosystem mein we start with the first level. For every food chain, the very first level is occupied always by the plants. So in a grassland, what type of the plants will be available? Grasses, right? So that makes the first level of this food chain, that are the grasses. Okay, for this grassland ecosystem, these are the grasses. Now further, grasses in a grassland ecosystem are eaten up by the organisms like grasshoppers. And when you put this arrow, just make sure that the arrow opens its head, that is the arrow head that is open towards the organism which is eating. Okay, not the organism which is eaten. This is eating the grass, so the arrow should be open towards the grasshopper. Whenever we have to eat, kaise khate hum? By opening our mouth, and opening the mouth makes an arrowhead. Okay, so this has to open the mouth, and that is an arrowhead towards it. Arrowheads galat ho gaye to pura food chain galat ho jayega. Okay, next is, after the grasshoppers, the next organism who feeds on the grasshoppers are the frogs. After this, the frogs, they are eaten up by snakes. Snakes are further eaten up by the higher organisms like that of eagles or vultures, etc. Got it? So this is the chain, that is the grassland ecosystem's food chain. Got it? Done. Now in this, when you are to write these levels, all the trophic levels, jab aapko likhne hain, तब आपने क्या करना है, स्टार्टिंग फ्रॉम द बेस लेवल. यू नो ग्रासेस आर फोटोसिंथेटिक, ग्रासेस आर फोटोसिंथेटिक, सो दे विल बी कॉल्ड एज प्रोड्यूसर्स. सो दे विल बी ऑक्यूपाइंग द फर्स्ट लेवल, एंड द ट्रॉफिक लेवल नंबर वन इज दैट ऑफ द प्रोड्यूसर्स. प्रोड्यूसर्स विल ऑलवेज बी प्रेजेंट एट द बेस ऑफ द फूड चेन. फर्स्ट ऑर्गेनिजम्स ऑफ द फूड चेन, प्राइमरी ऑर्गेनिजम्स ऑफ द फूड चेन, दे आर ऑलवेज प्रोड्यूसर्स. Because they are the ones which only synthesizes the food. None of the other can synthesize. They only consume the food. Right? Getting the things? Then coming to the next. अब देखो, अब यहाँ पे आपने जैसे मैं लिख रही हूँ बच्चे वैसे ही लिखना है इसको, ठीक है? Producers हो गया first level, right? अब बाकी सारे क्योंकि consume कर रहे हैं तो इनको हम क्या बोलेंगे? They will be all called as consumers, right? So all these members, that is from here till the grasshopper, these all are what? They are consumers. So these are all consumers. But if I say that I'm talking about the frogs, and I say that there is one of the consumers I'm talking for, will you be able to locate which consumer am I saying? No, that will be a confusion. अगर मैं simple बोलूँ कि मैं किसी consumer की बात कर रही हूँ, तो आपको कैसे पता चलेगा कि मैं किसके बारे में सोच रही हूँ? ठीक है, that will be a confusion. So for that, here are specific locations which have been provided. Every trophic level has given a specific name. What are those? These are the first consumers. Grasshoppers are the first consumers. इसको ध्यान से समझ लो, ये numericals में अगर आप ये words नहीं समझ पाए तो numericals answers आपके सही नहीं आएंगे. ठीक है, ध्यान से समझ लो how I'm writing this. So grasshoppers are the first consumers. The first consumers को हम लिखते हैं primary consumers. दिस इज वन नॉट, वन नॉट आप ऊपर कहीं या अलग से कहीं पे लिख लीजिए, दिस वन नॉट स्टैंड्स फॉर प्राइमरी इन बायो, वन नॉट स्टैंड्स फॉर प्राइमरी, वी कॉल इट एज प्राइमरी कंज्यूमर नाउ. गॉट इट, डन. नेक्स्ट इन अ सीरियल ऑर्डर, फ्रॉग्स विल नाउ बी कॉल्ड एज, वॉट इज द नेम गिवन टू द फ्रॉग्स देन, दे आर सेकेंडरी कंज्यूमर्स. Right, this two not that stands for secondary. Similarly, the snakes occupy the third consumer level. बच्चे ये खाली जगह छोड़नी है, इसमें अभी कुछ नहीं लिखना, ठीक है? Leave some space vacant also. This is three prime, or sorry, not three prime, three not. This is three not, and this three not is called as tertiary. We use the term tertiary here. That are the third consumers in a chain, third consumers, tertiary consumers. Similarly, these will be the fourth, quaternary. ठीक है, लेकिन ये last भी हैं. Fourth तो हैं, पर ये last हैं. जो last in a chain होते हैं, उनको हम top word से signify करते हैं. So these are last in a chain, hence top consumers. Got it? Right? After this. These were all consumers. अब अगर मैं आपको बोलूं that tertiary consumers, I'm talking about some tertiary consumers. You yourself will locate. Yes, I'm talking about snakes. है ना? तो आपको यहाँ पे clear हो गया कि now I'm talking about snakes. I'm talking about frogs. That is the secondary consumer. Okay? You also know that the consumers are further of two types: herbivores and carnivores. Herbivores कौन होते हैं? That which feed on the plants. Herbivores are those that which feed on the plants. So grasshopper, along with being a primary consumer, it is also occupying another trophic level, the same trophic level, which can be named differently as herbivores. Can we say? कह सकते हैं इसको? Four degree मैंने बोला, ये भी सही है, four भी लिख सकते हैं, quaternary बोलते हैं उसको, लेकिन क्योंकि ये last है तो इसलिए top से signify करेंगे. हम ये टॉप वर्ड लिख के बता देते हैं कि इसके आगे कुछ नहीं है, ठीक है? आगे कोई चेन में ऑर्गेनिज्म नहीं है. देन कमिंग टू दीज, अब देखो ये अगर हर्बीवोर हैं, तो ये सारे फ्लैश ईटर्स हैं. क्या हैं ये? कार्निवोर्स, है ना? सो नाउ ऑल दीज आर द कार्निवोर्स फ्रॉम हेयर टू दिस, ऑल दीज आर कार्निवोर्स, राइट? सो गिव देम अ कॉमन नेम फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल, दीज ऑल आर कार्निवोर्स. Got it? The carnivores. Now for carnivores, this is the first carnivore. ये first carnivore है ना? So क्या लिखेंगे हम इसको? This is primary carnivore. Primary carnivore. Are you getting? पक्का? Got this? Primary carnivores. Similarly, these are secondary carnivores. And these are tertiary but top, so we write top carnivores, right? Now here lies the confusion. When we say secondary consumer, तो बच्चा क्या करते हैं? Secondary consumer, secondary carnivore, दोनों को confuse कर देते हैं. And your answer will not be giving me the answer for frog. Your answer will give me for snake, and that is totally wrong, है ना? So this is the only that why I have told you. कि आपको ये अच्छे से सुनना है, कंज्यूमर कौन है, कार्निवोर कहाँ से शुरू हो रहे, कंज्यूमर कहाँ से शुरू. क्लियर? एनी कंफ्यूजन टू एनी वन? काइंडली रेज अप योर हैंड फॉर लोकेटिंग ऑल द ट्रॉफिक लेवल्स. इज इट क्लियर? हाँ जी. सो नेक्स्ट इज द फूड चेन ऑफ द फॉरेस्ट इकोसिस्टम. नाउ फॉर फॉरेस्ट इकोसिस्टम, व्हाट आर द प्लांट्स देयर? ऑल काइंड ऑफ द प्लांट्स आर प्रेजेंट इन अ फॉरेस्ट. सो वी राइट the plants as a base. ठीक है, ये बच्चे जब लिखेंगे आप तो इनको सेम सेम लेवल्स पे लिखना, ठीक है? सेकेंड हेयर, देन थर्ड हेयर, कॉन्टिन्यू दिस, राइट? कॉन्टिन्यू दिस, है ना? सेम लेवल, ताकि आपको पता रहे कि इसमें भी फूड चेन में कौन कौन से लेवल्स हैं. क्लियर? ग्रास ऑपर्स के आगे, यानी कि हर्बीवोर्स इन द केस ऑफ द फॉरेस्ट इकोसिस्टम. हर्बीवोर्स कौन है फॉरेस्ट इकोसिस्टम में? ऑर्गेनिजम्स लाइक दैट ऑफ डियर and air is eating the plant, so arrow like this. Similarly, the first consumer, second consumers, but the first carnivores, they are the tigers or the lions. So that is the tiger which feeds on the flesh of deer. Done. So this is a three trophic levels food chain. If you get to have a question to construct a food chain with five trophic levels, you can write that. If with three trophic levels, you can write this. Right? Similarly, for five levels, we have an aquatic ecosystem as well. Occupying the base level in aquatic ecosystem, the plants that which occupies the base for the food chain in aquatic ecosystem are called as phytoplanktons. What do we call them? Phytoplankton. It is phytoplanktons. ठीक है, फाइटो प्लैंकटॉन्स. नाउ द नेक्स्ट ऑर्गेनिजम्स फीडिंग ऑन द फाइटो प्लैंकटॉन्स, सेम लेवल आपने कंटिन्यू करना है. ठीक है, दैट आर द जू प्लैंकटॉन्स. अगेन प्लैंकटॉन वर्ड इज सेम बट इट इज सफिक्स्ड, सॉरी प्रीफिक्स्ड बाय जू. जू सिग्निफाइज एनिमल्स. जू प्लैंकटॉन्स आर द लार्वे ऑफ द फिशेस. ठीक है, ये लार्वे होते हैं जो कि हर्बीवोरस होते हैं, फिशेस नहीं, सिर्फ लार्वे. राइट, सो देन जू प्लैंकटॉन्स आर फर्दर ईटन अप बाय स्मॉल फिशेस. दीज आर द कार्निवोर मेंबर्स. टाइगर के सामने, ये वाले लेवल के सामने लिखेंगे आप. देन इज द नेक्स्ट लेवल दैट ऑफ द सेकेंडरी कार्निवोर्स, दैट इज ऑक्यूपाइड बाय लार्ज फिशेस. Large fishes, and last that of top consumer, top carnivore, that is occupied by the organisms, bird organisms like cranes or the bigger fishes like sharks. Got it? Just complete this. Hanji, cranes are the birds that which feed on the fishes. हाँ जी बच्चे, कंप्लीट दिस टेबल क्विकली.